going through the process, like being, of discovering who I am, growing as an artist, growing in craft, growing with ideas. I made several edits. We made several edits to the album before we felt that it was ready to be presented. And I feel like it's a good project. Hey, I didn't see you coming. I feel like this project is definitely representative of where I am right now in this moment. It's called Nebuchadnezzar. And Nebuchadnezzar, the meaning of that is kind of multi-layered. Nebuchadnezzar being the historical figure who helped to rebuild Babylon. We know Babylon as being the city of excess and decadence and opulence and depravity as well. So the album is symbolic of the eventual fall of Babylon, because if realness isn't there, if it's just about like the aesthetic of it, or if it's just about like what, how much you can accumulate or how much you can grow, you know, not organically, but how much you can grow, like bigger, or you know, how much you can amass, it eventually falls, it eventually comes to an end. And a lot of my projects, they come around in cycles. So I had Ether Wars, and then Babylon came before that, and then this is Nebuchadnezzar, which is symbolic of the fall of Babylon. And then Nebuchadnezzar also is kind of a play on the name of the ship in the Matrix. Nebuchadnezzar was, you know, the ship that came to free the people from sleep, came to free the people from slavery, came to free the people from a space of artifice and brought them into reality. And that's what this album is, the intention of this album is. So that's the other meaning for Nebuchadnezzar. The artwork was done by Scam. He is an artist that contributed his amazing skills to Tribe Called Quest, Beats, Rhymes, and Life album, Eminem's, what's the album he did?
Slim Shady LP.
The Slim Shady LP for Eminem. And so it was inspired by this brother named Imhotep. He did a piece for me, and the design was very similar to this. Scam took like kind of like the framework for it and then embellished on it. And it incorporates a lot of important elements. So like you have the elements, you have fire, wind, you have water in there somewhere. And then to me, like the essence of royalty that you see with the crook and you see with the headdress is symbolic of royalty, which is of an earthly embodiment. He just incorporated so many pieces from the hay root, symbolic of protection, and then I have the hand of Fatima on my hands, the protection as well, the serpent energy on the forehead, the wisdom and rebirth, and you know, so like he captured so much of who I feel that I am and who I feel that we are, you know, what we can be, in this one picture, and me coming out of the ethers, you know, just kind of symbolic of me being in this world, but not necessarily of this world. And the power of destruction is in my hand, but I also have the power of creation with the serpent, you know, which has been symbolic of fertility as well. So I just think that it's just the perfect just visual for what we're trying to convey on the album. So yeah, that's it in a nutshell. So without further ado, we'll just pop it off.
Let's get one thing crystal clear. I am not here to play with your feelings or save your career. My statement's severe, like razor edges on a paper veneer. Cut through exteriors cleaner than Windex on a mirror. I'm non-violent.